Today we're going to explain the differences between the two common RGB color profiles, sRGB and Adobe RGB. Right now, you're looking at a three-dimensional wireframe of the sRGB color profile. And you'll notice, if we take a look from the top down, along the bottom here, you'll see an outline in two dimensions of the size of the color gamut. And within ColorThink, we can quantify the number of colors in the gamut. And you'll notice here the gamut volume is approximately 900,000 different colors, a very big color profile. And sRGB is known as the lowest common denominator. So depending on whether you have a high-end ISO monitor or a low-cost Dell monitor, whatever it happens to be, it kind of dummifies the color so that the color looks consistent on each of those devices. Now, when we move up into the Adobe color profile, we're going to simply turn on here, and you'll notice along the bottom that it's gotten much larger, and you can see along the bottom here, especially in the cyan and the greens, and really pretty much the other colors, it's pretty much proportional, but you can see it's much larger. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to turn up the opacity, and you'll notice that the RGB color profile will pretty much encompass the entire sRGB profile, and notice how much larger it is now. And to give you an idea as far as to quantify the colors within Adobe RGB, we're looking at 1.3 million colors. So 900,000, almost 45% more colors than what you're going to get with sRGB. Now, how does this apply within Photoshop working with your images? We're going to boot up Photoshop and hide the background. And you'll get an idea. When I bring in an image here, you can tell the image looks really good. This is shot outdoors, and we're going to assign our profile. And you'll notice that right now we are in the sRGB color space. Image looks very good. If we toggle into the Adobe RGB color space, notice what happens with the color. The color greatly enriches and makes it much more lively. You'll notice where our sample points are that the data itself will not change. So we'll toggle back and forth. You'll notice the color shift, but the data itself did not change. That's important to note because what's happening is the Adobe RGB color profile is sending a different signal to Photoshop to display the color in a much more vibrant color space. Personally, what I do, anything with portrait or with skin, I will use the sRGB color profile. And if it's outdoors, using whether it's food or architecture, I'll go with the Adobe RGB color profile to get a much more vibrant looking print when I go to press. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and leave a comment. See you next time.